message. Although acceptable medical practice is a useful guide for the courts, it is for the courts to adjudicate what is the appropriate standard of care. So it is no longer relevant that experienced doctors testify to the propriety of what was done by the defendant doctor. It is the court which will say whether there was negligence. And that means that a layman is going to judge experts. With respect, this is nothing more than a load of absolute nonsense. The effect of the decision in Fu Fiona is that medical profession had to once again and at once to go into the extra care mode. Patients must not only be advised against risks, they must now also be subjected to unwanted tests. The blame now again shifts to the doctors. The allegation is that the tests are ordered to enrich the hospital, particularly if it is a private hospital. Costs multiply with no benefit in real terms. One can understand the chagrin felt by the doctors. General practitioners are particularly at risk because they will be found guilty of negligence unless they refer the patient to a specialist. And specialization has reached excessive limits. There used to be a time when there was a family doctor who knew all the ills of every member of the patient's family. And for those who were superstitious, especially among the Indians, there were doctors with lucky hands who were believed to have a cure to them, no matter what the ills. It is my belief that the difference between then and now is this. In those days, a patient died of a heart attack, now he dies from a heart attack. But it cannot be gainsaid that medical science has advanced and decreased the mortality rate. And when it comes to the question of research and experience, one cannot help but recall the words of Justice Bramwell, uttered so long ago as 1869, when he said, quote, "People do not furnish evidence against themselves simply by adopting a new plan in order to prevent the recurrence of an accident." I think that a proposition to the contrary would be barbarous. It would be, as I have often had occasion to tell juries, to hold that because the world gets wiser as it gets older, therefore it was foolish before. Close quote. Returning to the mainstream, the effects of Fu Fiona have since been brought under control by the fairly recent decision of the federal court in Dr. Hari Krishna against Bhagat Noor. The plaintiff had a giant retinal tear with detachment in his right eye. He was operated on by the first defendant doctor, with the second defendant doctor being the attendant anesthetist. Two procedures were performed. According to the finding made by the High Court, both were badly done. Before the second surgery, the plaintiff asked for Dr. Manavalan. I think everyone knows Tony Manavalan, the well-known anesthetist. He was not called in by the first defendant, who instead got in the second defendant. The court also found that the plaintiff had not been advised of the risks of bucking and blindness. The bucking had happened during the second surgery. The High Court found both the ophthalmologist and the anesthetist negligent. The Court of Appeal affirmed. A further appeal by leave to the Federal Court also failed. In the course of its judgment, the Apex Court held that Rogers and Whittaker, which was followed in Fu Fiona, with regard to the standard of care in medical negligence, was restricted only to the duty to advise of risks associated with any particular treatment. It did not extend to diagnosis and any proposed surgery. It did not extend to diagnosis and treatment. That's very important. With regard to the standard of care for diagnosis and treatment, the Bolland test still applies, subject to the qualifications stated in Bolitho. The Bolland test is essentially the doctor knows best. As long as there are two conflicting views on the acceptable medical practice and the defendant doctor acted based on one of them, he would be exonerated from liability. In short, the standard of care is decided by the medical profession, not by inexperienced laypersons like lawyers and judges. The Bolitho test is merely an extension of the Bolland test, which calls upon the court to analyze the logic and reasonableness of the conflicting medical opinion advanced by the defense before accepting the scene. Put simply, it means this. When a doctor decides upon a course of treatment, surgical or through the administration of drugs, he or she is duty-bound to advise on the specific risks of the course of treatment. That even if the patient does not ask. If this is not done, the risk occurs, and the risk occurs, the doctor is liable for negligence. But where the particular course of action was not negligent, but whether the particular course of action was or was not negligent would be decided by members of the medical profession, not by members of the legal profession. To recall the words of Justice McNair in Boland, a doctor is not guilty of negligence if he has acted in accordance with a practice accepted as proper by a responsible body of medical men skilled in that medical art. Put in another way, a doctor is not negligent if he is acting in accordance with such practice merely because of the body of opinion that takes a contrary view. So there can be two views about a matter. That does not mean that the doctor is negligent. So I answer the question put to me by the conveners of this conference in this way. At one time, the law forced doctors to practice defensive medicine. That is because of the erroneous decision of the apex court in Fufiona. Today, that is no longer the case. Therefore, doctors, please do not worry too much. The lawyer is no longer in your backyard. But this does not entitle the medical profession to take a laid-back attitude to diagnosis and treatment. I'm given to understand by several senior members of the medical profession that doctors, especially recent qualifiers from local universities, are there who do not know even how to perform an appendectomy. They nevertheless carry licenses to treat patients. It is my earnest plea to all of you not to allow them to become James Bonds with a license to kill. If that happens, the law will rise to meet the challenge. And you then cannot blame the court for looking over your shoulder. Thank you very much.